everybody. Thanks for coming to our special birthday kirtan. We're actually celebrating four of our birthdays, which is what we were just saying. Doris is next week, and Anja's was at the beginning of the month. Michael's was, what, the 24th? Yeah, Monday, and mine was Wednesday. So.
Wow.
Yeah. So we have a really fun set to share with you today. Where's my sheets? And, so yeah, we have song sheets. Does everybody have one?
Thank you.
chant with less interruptions this time, so that we can stay in the energy of it. This next one is Ganesha.
Sharanam, 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 Sharanam,
you're starting to feel the vibes by now. Just be free with it as well. I see some of you moving your seat, just let go. That's what I'm saying. This is one of my favorite songs, this next one. Everybody. Oh, so yeah, right. Yeah. So over here we have Michael on drums and my mom. And Ragani, who is my favorite person of all time. And you probably all know her, but if not, I'll tell you she's an amazing Kirtan artist and actually inspired me to start Kirtan in the first place. And I'll tell a short story right now. I found her like 6 years ago from Spotify. I was writing my book at the time, and I was in my little meditation, and this song comes up on my Spotify radio, and I had to come out of my meditation. I'm like, I don't know who this is, but it's like magical. And it was Ragani, and so I started listening to her then, and I went like 2 years, I think, before I realized that she was in Milwaukee, and then I made it my life goal to go see her. And that was only a year ago, so we've come far away since then. But we got her here. I want to also thank the community for coming together to pitch in to get her here, to fly her here, because we had this dream. Yeah, thank you. But yeah, we had this, Ananta and I, oh, I did introduce everybody, Doris and Ananta, guitar. But yeah, Ananta and I had this vision, and like, we need to get Ragani here, and it happened, so. We're super excited to have you.
Thank you.
Yeah. So, what else? Was there something else? Okay, that's it. So we're going to do this Ekong Kar. Yeah, that's what I was going to say. This is one of my favorites of all time. And we actually just sort of made our own version out of this melody, so I hope you like it.
Satana, see why I hate you.
take a few moments of silence after each one. You've noticed just chanting like this, and the repetitive nature of these mantras is really stilling for the mind. And especially what's really powerful and special about Kirtan is the community effect, and when we're all singing together, it's amplified in energy. And so the other thing that I sometimes do is to set an intention for this time, and it amplifies when we're together as well. So if you have something that you want to magnify in your life in a positive way, not a negative way, but a positive way, this is a good space to do that in. This next one, six-word chant, Om Mani Padme Hum, is again one of my favorites, and we're going to do this 108 times. So you have them all, yeah, okay. This is one of my favorites as well. Well, they're all my favorites, but I like this one. Is everybody comfortable? Oh, right, this one is together, so it's not call and response. We're just going to sing it together. Feel free to, like, take your stretch breaks as well, because when we go long, and might get tired of sitting.
Money. Oh, Yeah, I think so.
Yeah.
Just saying. So, Craig, could I have you just cut the lights in the back?
Yeah.
Or just dim them way down and just cut them completely. And there's one's way in the back. Yeah. So you guys don't need to see the words, right? I mean, I'm curious how many of you are really new to the Kirtan experience, like this is your first time ever hearing Kirtan? Three, four, five, all right. Well, welcome, and if you're totally confused by now, just hang in there, you'll start to get it. We have, we do a couple more songs, and as Courtney said, it really is something about tuning into the heart. So this next song is something that's really simple. It just has two words, Rama Rama, and might throw in a Hare Rama. And Ram, one of the words of Ram, brings you right into the heart center. Ram's considered to have been somebody that was named Ram even in India, that followed his Dharma, which is the life path. And so this evokes that idea of bringing us back to our center and bringing us to our life path. That being said, if you forget the words and mess it up, we've got little people that are monitoring in the middle of the room, so you know, don't mess this one up, because there's only two words. I mean, I'm just saying, there's only two words. So don't do that. And see how you feel, you know, for those of you who are experienced with this and those of you who aren't, see how you feel as you're chanting. You know, see, when I do the workshops with the chanting, part of it is to see how far in your body can you feel the chant, the sound go that you're uttering. And then to see how far outside the body, because the vibrations are beyond just, you know, what's happening in our body, what it goes beyond. And they're actually beyond what goes on in this room. And people say, well, how far do they go? And my teacher used to say they go as far as your mind can take them, because the subtlest form of matter is thought. So when we do the chanting, we're carrying this sound with our thought, and we can reach whatever level, whatever person you'd like to reach. So that being said, any questions? Now's your chance. And now the door is closed. When I want to welcome Doug up here, where's Pascal? Pascal, you want to come up and sing with us? Come on up and sing with us. Make a little space for you. Sit right in front of us. Space with some shakers back here. Pascal leads Kirtan in Minneapolis. So we've got lots of I'll scoot forward. Yeah, you can bring your big cushion and monitor from behind. So if you haven't been to Kirtan Minneapolis, you can go see Pascal, and you lead them too with her, right?
Yes.
And Doug also leading in Minneapolis. It's catching, and it's contagious, so I'll warn you, once you start doing Kirtan, you'll find yourself starting to sing strange words in the shower, and while you're driving, and you'll have your windows down, you've got to watch some of the chants make you speed a little bit, and you might get a ticket. I actually got a letter from somebody who was listening to our CD and did get a ticket. And so just be forewarned. Mm-hmm. play the guitar back there?
No.
Okay, see? Turn it up. Alright, this song is serious. We're gonna rock the house with this one. So no sleepiness or feeling the bliss of silence. This is gonna be the bliss of raucous celebration. And it's actually a chant, Hare Krishna Govinda Mohamurari, and for those of you, many of you sound like you're seasoned kirtanwalas here, so this is not much of a surprise to chant the word Krishna, but for those who are new and maybe freak out when you see the word Krishna because you wonder what's going to happen when you say the word, just say it now, see, nothing happens. Krishna, Krishna. So Krishna is actually about love. It comes from the Sanskrit word Krishti, he means to draw to you, and Krishna Mohan Murari is the one that entrances you or delights you or draws you in, and it's said to reside, this energy, in the heart. We're talking about the energy of the heart and brain earlier today, and I've made a joke a few times that, you know, we thought for, or many people thought, the science community thought that we were run by our brain for years, right? And they found that it's actually the heart center that has far more electromagnetic energy and has a much greater influence to draw things in and to do the work that we do. It's also funny because, you know, we thought the brain, according to the science community, was in charge. But when you think about it, who do you think told you that? Right? Your brain. Your brain's like saying, I'm the one that's in charge, right? So we've since kind of come to our senses and realized the heart's a lot quieter about it, but it has a much bigger impact. So, Hare Krishna Govinda Mohan Murari, this is a chant, and it's a chant for that love. And so we've got two shakers here. I do want them back because they are my like pure gold, you know, titanium shakers, and they've got GPS devices on them, so if you walk out with them, we're going to find you. But yeah, roll them out there and have people, we want to hear some shaker noise, little sounds. And I think that's all I have to say for this. There's a lot of love in this chant. It's one of the chants I used to do with my teacher many, many, many moons ago when I was, I'm still 29, but I was a little younger then. So it was one of our favorites, and I'm so happy to be chanting it with you guys here tonight.
Hare Mana Bhikari. Japan. Hare Krishna, Govinda, Hare Rama. Hare Rama.
of my life.
Mandatory ohms. Close it off and take it into your heart, and then imagine sending it out to all those that you love, and then even beyond to all those others.
Thank you, everybody, for coming. We're going to bring food down in a minute, so just sit tight. What?
One more.
Oh, we're doing an encore. We only get her so many times, you know.
This one is a two-hour chant, so we're going to I'll be done at 9:10. I'll end a little early at 9 in case you have to leave. It's okay if you're hungry, take some food with you. It'll probably be cold, but... So this one, there are no written words on your sheet, I don't think. The words are, you can repeat after me, Ong Namo,
Ong Namo.
Bhagavate,
Bhagavate.
Vasudevaya.
Vasudevaya.
Ong Namo Vasudevaya, Ong Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. And the second line is, let's see, how does it go? Haribol, Haribol. You have to repeat after me or you'll forget.
Haribol, Haribol.
Krishna, Krishna.
Krishna, Krishna.
And that's it. I think that's it. There's some other words in there somewhere. It's hard to remember them until you're singing them, but you can, if you get lost, you can just say watermelon or something. It'll look like you're saying something and nobody will notice the difference until it's too late.
Oh,
Ragani's website is raganiworld.com.
It's my world.
It's Ragani's world. So she does kirtans every 3 months, usually. About every 3 months. In Milwaukee. And so go to her website and go to her events. And the next one is February 2nd. Yeah. And my website is teachingsfromgod.com, and I also have a couple of books up there, which are $15 if you want one. So,
and there's some flyers up there for, I'm doing a retreat, like a purification retreat for head meditation, breathing, sound, stuff like that. We're also taking it, leading another tour to India this fall, so if you want to be really drenched in Kirtan and the experience of India, Kata Bliffen and I are leading a tour to northern India, going to Tunganath. We're going up from Delhi to Rishikesh to Tunganath, and Lake Deorantal, which is really incredible. You will feel like you don't even want to speak when you get up there. We're actually at the level of the clouds, so you would be right, be able to look full circle of the Himalayas around, you know, when the sun comes up. It's really amazing. So you can check out the website. There's a flyer over there. It's indiasacredretreat.com. It's also on ragani.com. So lots of things happening, and there'll be lots more little kirtan events going on. We had a request for one in August. Who knows? Maybe we'll do one in August.
Yes. We vote yes.
Yes. Have you guys been to any of the festivals around, like Bhakti Fest? If some of you have been to Bhakti Fest,
yes.
And there's a Midwest Yoga Kirtan Festival going on that Gary's organizing this year. And Kata Bliffer usually runs the Milwaukee Kirtan Fest, however, or Kirtan Fest Milwaukee, rather. This year, it's rumored that she may not do a whole festival. We may just do a day of events because of other things going on. Maybe do that next year, so you can stay tuned. Last few years, David Newman has come in town. Those of you who know Durga Das. We don't know if it'll be David or Sean or Brenda, one of the people who will probably come in and usurp the Milwaukee Kirtan for a day. Yeah, so here it comes. We can watch them in silence.
So we made khichdi and homemade bread and homemade cake and all thanks to Ananta, yeah.
Oh.